Kids Church and everybody else who's watching. It's so great to be back with another Kids Church session for you guys to be doing at home with your families. I had a great rest last week, but I also enjoyed seeing everything that you guys have been up to. Thank you so much for sending me your videos and your photos. It was so fun to see you all. We're going to do our quick fire questions. This is where I ask you guys a question, you press pause on the video and give everybody in your family a chance to answer the question. And it's called quick fire because it's the first thing that pops into your head. This morning we've got a bit of a fruit theme going on, you'll find out why later. So your first question on quick fire is, what is your favourite fruit? If you could have the perfect day, what would it look like? Would you rather see God, like actually see him with your eyeballs, or have him answer one prayer exactly as you've asked for it to be answered? What is your favourite thing about doing church at home? What has been the best thing about this week? Has there been a time you've asked God for help this week? We're going to play a game and it's called Hot or Cold. It's a bit of a variation on hide and seek. So you need to go and find yourselves a small object. I've just got a small tub of polos. And when you've found your object, you need to choose somebody who's going to be the seeker. So that's just one person. So they just need to close their eyes, go and sit in the corner of a room, keep their eyes tightly closed. And then everybody else in your family needs to go and agree on a hiding place for your small item. It can be anywhere in your whole house. So they need to run off, disappear, go and hide the small item. And then once it's hidden, you need to go back and get your seeker. Now their job is to find the item, but they are gonna get a little bit of help. So those people that have hidden it, you can use the words hot or cold to tell the person who's seeking how close they are to the object. So if they're really, really, really far away from the object, then they're cold, they're freezing, they're practically in the Antarctic, they're nowhere near it. And the closer they get to the object, you can start saying warmer, getting warmer, you're hot, you're boiling, you're on Mars, you're so hot, you're so close to it. And hopefully that will help the seeker narrow down where the object is. And then once they've found it, hooray, then you can change over who seeks and who hides. And you can play as many rounds of this as you want. So enjoy playing hot or cold. We're gonna do our share slash prayer chair. And this is an opportunity for you to go around in your family and share stories of where you have seen God answering your prayers in the recent weeks. Or it's an opportunity for you to pray about those things where maybe God hasn't answered your prayers yet. So you're either sharing about things that God has done or praying about things that you're still waiting for God to do. And if God has answered a prayer, then we need to say thank you. So after everybody shared, you can shout 1, 2, 3, thank you, God! Because it's always good to give God thanks. We are doing a brand new series on something called the Fruit of the Spirit. This week is an introduction week just to help us understand what the fruit of the Spirit is. Here is an apple tree. What does a tree need to help it grow apples? Press pause on the video and have a little chat in your family. I can think of three main things that this tree would need to help it grow apples. So see if you can think of three things this tree would need. Go.
So this apple tree needs sun and it needs rain and it needs some good soil to help it to grow. And when it's got all of those things, it will produce apples as its fruit.
We are a little bit like this tree. If you remember a couple of weeks ago, we talked about the Holy Spirit coming to live in us. And when we have God's Holy Spirit living in us, we can grow fruit just like a tree does. That's what makes us a little bit like a tree. And we know that this apple tree needs sun, rain, and good soil to help it grow fruit. But we don't need those things. What we need is we need to know God, we need to learn from God, and we need to listen to God. And that helps us grow good fruit. Now, I know some of you are panicking and thinking, but Becky, I don't want apples and oranges and bananas growing off my body. That's just weird. Thankfully, you don't need to worry. We don't grow actual fruit. So don't worry, there's no bananas that are going to start growing off your ears. We grow a different kind of fruit. It's called spiritual fruit. That's why we call it fruits of the Spirit. So let's have a look at what it is that we do grow. I want you to go and find a grown-up Bible in your house. What I mean by a grown-up Bible is one that has all of the books and all of the words and all of those little numbers. So your children's story Bibles aren't going to have in what I need you to look for. So you need to go and find yourselves a grown-up Bible. Press pause while you go and do that. Once you've got your Bible, I want you to look up the book of Galatians. So it might be that grown-ups, you look up the book of Galatians, which is in the New Testament. And then kids, I want you to find, look at these big numbers here. I want you to see if you can find big number 5 in the book of Galatians. Let's keep going. There it is in my Bible. And once you've found the big number 5, you've then got to go, oh, through here and see if you can find the teeny teeny tiny number 22. So in my Bible it's all the way over here and you need 22 and 23. And what I want you to do is I just want you to read those two verses together. They're two very short sentences, but what they do is they list what the fruit of the Spirit is, that fruit that we can grow. It lists them all. So read those two sentences once you've found them, big number 5, little number 22 and 23, and count how many fruits you can spot in those two verses. Go. Did you spot them all? There's 9 fruits of the Spirit. They are love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Whew, that is a lot of fruit that we can grow. Don't worry if you don't understand all of those words or you don't quite understand how the fruit grows. What we're going to do over the next few weeks is we're going to look in detail each week at one of the fruits that we can grow. And we're going to look at somebody in the Bible who was growing that fruit as well. And we're going to be asking the Holy Spirit to help us grow that fruit. For our connecting time, I want you to draw your favourite fruit. So get a bit of paper and some colouring pencils or pens. And I want you to try and make your fruit look as yummy scrummy on paper as it does in real life. So go draw your favourite fruit. I want you to go back and have a look at that list of all the fruits of the Spirit that's in the Bible. So you might need to go and find that passage again if you've closed your Bibles. And I want you to have a look and decide which of the fruits is probably the one that you need the most help with. So it might be that you're really, really super good at loving, but you're not very good at being patient, and so that's what you need help with. You might be super, super good at being kind, but you might need a bit of help being more joyful and happy. So have a look at the list and decide which one is the one you need the most help with. And I want you to write that onto your fruit. And now I want you to just spend some time with your family praying for each other, for the Holy Spirit to grow all of the fruits in you, but especially the one that you've written down that you need help with. So just go around each person in your family and just pray for the Holy Spirit to grow the fruit and to help them, especially with the one thing that they've written down on their fruit. We're going to worship and we're going to sing God, We Love You. So jump up onto your feet and enjoy telling God just how much you love Him.
Love the Lord with all your heart, all your mind and all your strength. Oh, love the Lord. Oh, love the Lord. Love the Lord with all your heart, all your mind and all your strength. Oh, love the Lord. Oh, love the Lord. Love the Lord with all your heart, all your mind and all your strength. Oh, love the Lord. Oh, love the Lord. Love the Lord with all your heart, all your mind and all your strength. Oh, love the Lord. Oh, love the Lord.
Say a closing prayer for us. So Holy Spirit, I thank you for the fruits that you enable us to grow, and I pray that you would just show us how to do that and show us where we need to grow in the next few weeks as we explore each one of these fruits in detail. And I pray that you would continue to protect and keep us all safe. Amen. Kids Church, it's been great to have another session for you guys at home. And I won't be back next week, but instead we're going to do a family celebration because it's Father's Day. So I hope you're really excited about that. I am, and I will see you the week after next. See you later.